Kids, welcome. This is American Ballet Theatre Heals, and it's a special program for you guys in the hospital, and we hope you enjoy it. It's a family day today. This is the family theme, and we've got two families of musicians who play, some of whom, or maybe most of whom, have actually played in the ABT Orchestra at various times. This concert is actually dedicated to Dr. Barry Weber, the late Dr. Barry Weber, who was a surgeon at Mount Sinai in Queens and the husband of Harriet Clark, who is the principal teacher of the ABT Jacqueline Onassis School of Dance. So my connection to ABT is that I started, I think I was maybe 13 years old, I started in 1976. I went to my first rehearsal of Sleeping Beauty, having never played it, having never played the piccolo. I'm a flutist and a piccolo player now. And went to that rehearsal and we started playing, and there's in the prologue of the Sleeping Beauty, there's a little number called The Canary That Sings. So fortunately, I didn't have stage fright because I didn't know it was going to be a solo. So I just played it. So I'll play you a little bit of it. This is The Canary That Sings on piccolo. There you have it. Thank you. Thank you. I have a little bit of Zoom fright, not stage fright. Isn't that interesting? So I'll just tell you that there's another connection, a quick connection. My partner, Dr. Michael Tosi, some of you may know, he may show up in some of your rooms. And he's also an amateur clarinet player and a guitarist and sings songs. So you may see him, and that's my connection with Mount Sinai and you guys, and his connection with music and us. I'm now going to introduce you to the Goldberg family. You can all wave over there if you want. And it's Mark Goldberg, who is the principal bassoon in the ABT Orchestra, and his wife, Janet Arms, who is a fantastic flutist and has played in the New York City Opera as well as the San Francisco Ballet, and their daughter, Jessie Goldberg, who's a pianist, who coincidentally has accompanied my son, Muir, when they were both at school at Bard College. They both graduated in the music school there. So now I'm going to turn it over to Mark Goldberg, and he'll tell you a little bit about what they're going to play.
Thank you, Diva. I'm so glad that we could be here today. I've been part of the ABT family for about 10 years now. And when things are tough, families come together. So I'm really glad that our family could join you guys here at the hospital. We chose three beautiful pieces to play for you today. Sometimes when words are difficult, music is better. And so we hope that you really enjoy these. The first is the Adagio from A Flute Sonata by C.P.E. Bach. And the second is a song by Franz Schubert, originally for soprano and tenor, that we are adapting for flute and bassoon. And the last is one of three pieces by Ernest Bloch, Scenes from a Jewish Life, and this one is called Prayer. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you. That was just beautiful, all of you. And you kids that are there, we hope you're applauding, even if we can't hear you. And I'd like to tell you that it's so different when you get to hear people live. And not only do you see these two families that have musicians in them, but we consider ourselves a family amongst ourselves as musicians, not only in the ABT Orchestra, but as freelancers playing in New York City, and we miss each other. We don't get to play together. So these families are lucky they have members that they can play together with. So I am going to go on and introduce John Manassi, who is the principal clarinet player in the ABT Orchestra. And I'm just going to say, and his wife, Pam Greitzer, and two of his children, Alec and Jordan. And John, I think you were Alec's age when you joined the orchestra. Is that true?
It is very nearly true, because I've been playing with ABT since 1988. And what, you know, this is such a beautiful day for us to share the big ABT family and the immediate family with these kids, and also all the wonderful, amazing people taking care of them. And here's a very interesting thing. Mark Goldberg's family is very dear to us. In fact, Mark Goldberg and I have known each other since I was a year younger than Jordan in the Juilliard pre-college, and that's how long we've been together. So, you know, music creates family, extended and immediate, and we are so thrilled to be here today to do this, Diva.
I know. Lifelong friends and colleagues, it's true.
Yeah. Yes, yes. So I'd like to introduce our pieces and performers. We'll start with Jordan. Jordan's 13, and he'll play two solo piano pieces, one by Bach in Allemande, and then he'll play the famous Chopin, very lively, black key etude. It's called black key because most of the notes are on the black keys. So if not, he says all of the notes are. Okay. So we yield to Jordan, and then we'll tell you more about the program as it goes on. Jordan. Thank you. Luke Jordan, take a bow. Take a bow. Yay. Oh, it's your turn. It's Mom's turn. Okay.
Hi. So next, we are so happy to be here with you. We're going to play, Jordan and I, a beautiful, very famous piece together by the composer Camille Saint-Saëns. And he wrote this for a small orchestra where each instrument represents an animal. And in this case, it's the swan, the beautiful swan. So the swan is floating on the river, and it's also made into a ballet that performed many times. And so we are going to play that. And you can think of this beautiful, beautiful swan floating away at the end, going farther and farther away on the lake.
That was so beautiful, and beautiful for us to watch our family members offer that to you. We'd like to end the program today with some fun, and this is a special duet that Alec and I play. It's a jazz duet, and as you know, at 7 o'clock every night here in New York City, and indeed around the world, we always applaud our healthcare workers, caregivers, all you amazing people. And our contribution has always been to open our window. We live on the second floor, and we play this duet outside, but you never get to hear it, so we're really happy to offer this to you now. And we wish all of you kids in there peace and healing and love, and thank you so much. So one, a two,
We have 1 minute left just to say thank you to all of you for being there. Thank you to the doctors and the caregivers and everybody who makes this possible. And to our wonderful conductor, David LaMarche, who's putting this all together. He's a fantastic pianist as well as a conductor and gives us much inspiration and joy all the time with his wonderful attitude. So please we hope you all get better fast and come hear us play live or come to the ballet soon as we can all do that.